eclipse fever. It's been going on here in the United States for a while, climaxing in the actual event yesterday. Now, people gathered, people traveled so many miles to be in a place where they could experience the total darkness. And they spoke about the very spiritual experiences and how they were keeping their special viewing glasses as souvenirs. And some people spoke as though this was a moment they'd remember their whole life long. Now, I know there are people who are eclipse chasers who go around the world to witness these events because you know what? There's a total eclipse somewhere on the planet every year. The thing is, it's often in some place that's so remote, there's no way to access it if you're a person. So I was watching, and where I live, there just was only a very slight dimming of the sun. So it wasn't a big deal. So I watched on the NASA channel and saw all these people in all these crowds and all the viewing. What I found most fascinating personally was the view from outer space from the space station, and those astronauts got to fly by 3 times. So here's an international crew, each person doing his or own part, having a specific task of covering, making videos, taking photos. And I can understand the spiritual connection of acting together for something like that. I have a little trouble understanding why this is such a big deal event. It didn't used to be, not on the scale it is now. And I think it's because of social media and because of all the hype that was going on, making a commercial event out of everything. When you look back across the world, you've got Stonehenge in England. You have the pyramids in Egypt. You have pyramids in South America. You have the mounds in South America. And these are all astronomical creations to predict the solstices. So if it was important to create a calendar for eclipses, it seems to me that someone would have done it, because if they had the genius to build these structures for prediction of the solstice, that it could be done for predicting eclipses. Now, the difference, big difference with eclipses, as the Earth moves closer to the moon, to the sun, how the relationships change over time, there'll be a difference and how often an eclipse can happen. So eventually, in a time when we're not going to have to worry about witnessing it, you won't be able to see an eclipse at all. Now, I'm a really spiritual person. In fact, I'm an ordained metaphysical minister. I spent most of my childhood and my teen years in the woods. I feel amazing when I'm in the woods. I love to witness the dancing shadows of a sun coming through the trees, to hear the babbling brook, to hear the bullfrog in the lake and the pond. And then I thought about, you know what's extraordinary is the monarch butterflies that fly thousands of miles every year, or the salmon that swim upstream, or the birds that will fly for thousands of miles, or the albatross that's not even on land for 10 months. All of these things, countless events in nature, they speak to my heart. So I don't get why the solar eclipse was such a big spiritual event to so many people. And I wonder if you'd do me a favor, it was for you. You please go ahead down below and share what it meant for you, what you felt, and why it was so important to you to experience it as you did. Now, if you live in North America, you can't help but be near Native American grounds. So I was wondering, what could it have been like back 100, 200 more years ago when suddenly the sun disappeared, if not completely, partially. And then there's a famous story in China of the emperor who actually put to death the astronomers responsible for predicting total eclipses because they failed to do so. Now back then they thought this was a dragon eating the sun, and the people would take to the streets with the pots and the pans and banging to make noise to chase the dragon away, which of course they succeeded in doing because the sun came back. So those all speak to my heart, and yet that eclipse just said nothing to me. Again, if it says something to you, would you please share that with us below? I'm Allie Bierman. You can find me at Your Relationship Intelligence.